activity area, and tons of vendors in the Brat Days Marketplace. So scrap those boring summer nights and grab family and friends for great brats, great beer, and great music from Separate Ways and Hairball at Brat Days in Sheboygan, August 3rd through the 5th. Presented by the Sheboygan Jaycees.
Oshkosh Waterfest.
Wisconsin's best community concert series prepares to run the table in August.
With four straight Thursdays of superb entertainment featuring the Wallflowers. With Better Than Ezra.
And Corey Chisholm.
The Bodines and Trapper Shack.
Pablo Cruz with Ambrosia.
John Kay and Steppenwolf and more.
This Thursday, August 3rd.
It's a Waterfest triple header with the Wallflowers.
Better Than Ezra.
Corey Chisel and the Wandering Sons. The Wallflowers arrive with one headlight, three Marlenas, and Sixth Avenue Heartache.
Just to name a few.
Better Than Ezra brings Extraordinary, Good, Tremble, and the King of New Orleans.
And many more to the Waterfest faithful.
Reserved area access VIP are available online.
Get this.
General admission is just $15 before 7 p.m. and a few bucks more after. Log on to waterfest.org for more info.
This week,
it's the Wallflowers and Better Than Ezra with Corey Chisel and the Wandering Sons.
It's your summer to rock.
Rock it at Waterfest.
Come early, pay less, and get more at Waterfest all summer long.
You know, Len, in this kind of weather, oh boy, I make my own gravy when I'm sleeping.
You know, Rick, that's probably not a good way to sell a mattress. But it is a good way to describe the benefits of the cooling technology you can find right now at Mattress Firm.
And right now, it is the coolest sleep sale ever.
Experience the latest cooling mattress technology and stop sleeping hot and making your own gravy at night.
That's right. You can beat the hot summer nights with free cooling bundle that they're offering. Get up to two free pillows and a free mattress protector with select purchases right now at Mattress Firm.
These mattresses are awesome. The Sealy iComfort Temp Touch and the new Beautyrest Black Memory Foam with black ice are just the ticket for those hot, steamy summer nights. But the deals won't last forever. Get into the coolest sleep sale ever at Mattress Firm.
Low prices on all your favorite brands during the big sale right now at Mattress Firm.
Like a Hampton and Rhodes Pillow Top Queen Mattress at just $209.99. The coolest sleep sale ever at Mattress Firm.
Save money.
Sleep happy.
The Community First Fox Cities Marathon to me means friendships, camaraderie.
I've met new people and made new friends. I had a voice in my head saying, you can't do this, you can't do this. And now I have a voice in my head that says, I can do this.
You can do this.
Do the full marathon or do the half.
You can walk or run.
Save money.
Register by July 31st. Sign up today at foxcitiesmarathon.org.
The Community First Fox Cities Marathon.
Presented by Myron Construction. Let's go!
This is a test of the emergency alert system. This is only a test. This has been a test of the emergency alert system. Equipment that can warn you if an emergency is being tested. If this had been an actual emergency, such as severe weather, chemical accident, or other emergency, official messages would have followed the alert tones. WAPL-FM serves the East Central Wisconsin area. This has been a test of the emergency alert system.
WAPL, Appleton, Green Bay, Oshkosh.
Yeah!
Blowing the top off the Security Libkey 920 Roofing Studio with 100,000 watts.
Menominee Casino Resort.
Menominee Casino Resort is heating up in August with their Summer Fever Frenzy promotion where you could win up to $1,500 cash every Saturday of the month. Check us out online to learn more about all the fun we have in store for you. From Throwback Thursdays, great food and drink specials, and all the free music, MCR and the Thunderbird Complex are your August entertainment destinations.
Menominee Casino, Casino Resort.
It's traffic.
Nice car horn.
Rock for the ride home.
Oh no! Come back! I hate my car horn.
The Traffic Jam on 105.7 WAPL.
All right, it is dinner time. You worked overtime. You have no time, but do not worry. Wendy's Quality Kids Meals, there for just $1.99 after 4 p.m. right on time at participating Wendy's for a limited time. Mile of Music Week. We got the garage set up, the WAPL Tundraland Mile of Music Garage presented by Stone Arch. Live performance coming from Sons of Kong momentarily. Make sure you check out the live video stream of the performances all week long, every morning at 9, every afternoon at 5, by going to WAPL.com. Before we get to them, it's Queen with Killer Queen on 105.7 WAPL.
Just like Marie Antoinette, a building remedy for Khrushchev and Kennedy. And at a time of invitation, you can't decline. Caviar and cigarettes, well-versed in etiquette, extraordinarily nice. She's a killer queen, gunpowder and gelatine, dynamite with a laser beam, guaranteed to blow your mind. To avoid complications, she never kept the same address. In conversation, she spoke just like a baroness. Little man from China went down to gauge her mind. But then again, incidentally, in that way, because she couldn't care less, fastidious and precise. She's a killer queen, gunpowder gelatine, dynamite with a laser beam, guaranteed to blow your mind. Momentarily out of action, temporarily out of class, you're absolutely right. She's out to get you. She's a killer queen, gunpowder gelatine, dynamite with a laser beam, guaranteed to blow your mind. Anytime. Recommended at the price, insatiable and appetite. Wanna try?
Rodgers waits, steps up, scrambles left, throws end zone, diving grab, touchdown!
105.7 WAPL.
9 a.m. every evening at 5 p.m. to present a different live band performing from our garage here at the WAPL studios, all presented by Stone Arch. The guys from Sons of Kong are in the garage with John Jordan right now. Hey, John.
Hey, Elwood. Yeah, we are surrounded by the Sons of Kong. Green Bay, Wisconsin. Rock?
Yeah.
Okay. So on there, I see it's garage blues-influenced rock and roll from Green Bay.
Yes, we are. We don't play in a garage. We play in a basement, but that's close enough.
Yeah. How's this for a garage? Have you ever actually played in a garage before?
Actually, technically, our first show was in Mike's garage.
Okay.
The bass player's garage. So
okay.
We're well-versed.
So you're well-versed in garage rock.
Yes.
You guys have a brand new album out. We've been digging it on WAPL. Homebrewed is just an acronym, S-O-K, right? It's nothing else weird or satanic or devilish that we have to work.
You know. We're just bad at spelling, so we just went with the abbreviation.
Just go with S-O-K. You're going to do a track right now. We've been playing on WAPL Homebrewed on the stream, WAPLHomebrewed.com, and on our Saturday show. Right now, I think we played it last week, but it's going to sound great live here. This is called L.A. It's Sons of Kong in the Rockin' Apple Tundraland Garage.
Think we'll go to L.A. They're getting big every day. I don't care what you say. I think we're leaving today. Oh, I wanna get it right. I wanna get it right before it's over. Go to New York. I'll write my songs in the park. Now go wherever you are. I'll live before it gets dark. Go to New York. I'll write my songs in the park. Knock out whoever you are. And I'll live before it gets dark.
Sons of Kong from Green Bay, L.A., off their latest S.O.K. release. Now, let's introduce the guys coming around here as we go. We'll start here.
Joe Masato, lead vocals, guitar.
Hey, Mike Jarvala, bass.
Chris McCullough, drums.
You got it.
Very good.
Right.
Yeah, we got it. Now, the new EP, S.O.K., available on Bandcamp streaming download. You guys recorded that locally. You want to talk a little bit about where you recorded it at the Refuge, correct?
We did. We got an awesome opportunity to record there. It's a great place. Just really cool experience, and everyone was great. Shout out to Corey Chisel. Thanks for having us.
Yeah. Sammy Farrell did a production on that for
Sam
you guys.
Sam did a great job.
Brilliant.
He's crazy. He's so good.
Sammy is really, really, really good about it. How about playing at the Refuge? Have you ever recorded anything in a non-studio space before like that?
We have not, and we've definitely never recorded in an old church, so that was new, and it was...
Was there some kind of reverence that it brought on with you guys?
Well, or? I mean, there always is, but just a little bit extra in that spot.
Yeah, it's a cool, cool place, and the Refuge is all just set up to create.
Yeah, absolutely.
And you could feel that out there when you do that, for sure. So you want to do another one off the latest EP, S.O.K.?
Yeah, we're going to do another one. Which one are we doing? Danger Queen, this
Danger
one's
Queen.
Called.
And here it is. Sons of Kong from Green Bay, Danger Queen. Danger Queen, Sons of Kong, in the WAPL Tundraland Mile of Music Garage, powered by a little Stone Arch Pizza here this afternoon. I was reading a little bit of a write-up on your band when you first kind of came on the scene a couple of years ago, let's say. And they said Green Bay Rock Band gets some groovy UK love. What was that about? Were you big in Britain?
We were not. I think Mike can take this one.
We were contacted by a journalist out of Boston, Ken McIntyre. And he found a track through Bandcamp, Back Again, which was on our second EP. And he just asked if we wanted to be part of Classic Rock Magazine, which is located in the UK.
That's pretty big. Because Classic Rock Magazine said, introducing rock and roll's wildest new beat combos, including Sons of Kong, amongst others. But, I mean, coming from Green Bay, and then all of a sudden you're in Classic Rock Magazine being talked about, across in England, like, what's going through your head at that point?
Well, I mean, the great exposure, number one. made a couple of fans out of that for sure. We have fans, England, France, who have bought our albums on Bandcamp, which is wonderful. Just being able to outreach our music like that.
It's good getting that exposure out there.
Oh, for sure.
And then is this the second album, third album?
It's the fourth EP.
Fourth EP then out of this. Okay, S.O.K. What's different this time around as it's the fourth one? I know the first one hits, and then all of a sudden sophomore album, you kind of get your legs under you a little bit, and then this fourth one, is there much fundamentally that's changed with this last album?
I would say the way that we, recorded the songs and played them is kind of the same, but we really wanted to push ourselves to kind of maybe have a new sound, or just, we didn't want to regurgitate the same tracks over and over again, so we really tried to kind of mix it up and do something new with this one.
Right, right.
The dynamics and sonically improve what we're doing, and there's only three of us. So.
Right. Well, there's great bands with three members, Rush, The Police,
Yeah.
I mean, that's... let's be honest.
Yeah, right,
the best
bands
all have three members, all right?
Yeah.
So, S.O.K. again, available on Bandcamp. iTunes also, guys?
Yep, yeah, we're on all that stuff. The interwebs, just punch in Sons of Kong.
Spotify.
Yep, Spotify.
Spotify is always good. All right, man, here we go. Let's do another one from S.O.K.
Yeah, this one's cool. It's called Vampire, and Mikey starts this one.
Telephone for your call.
by Sons of Kong from Green Bay off their SOK EP. That's called Vampire. You were talking about the process and sonically where you guys went with this new EP, SOK. How does that work in the dynamic of the band? Is there a lyric guy? Is there a word guy? Is there a sound? I mean, how does that, is it a collaborative effort when you guys sit down and decide to put out some new tunes?
Yeah, I mean, we don't have a specific way really that we do it, but usually I come up with like a little idea or a little nutshell, and then I kind of take it to practice. We play through it. You know, we kind of adjust parts around and we kind of build on it. Most songs happen like that. Every once in a while we write a song and it just is perfect and it just, we don't change anything. But usually it takes a little bit of tweaking and, you know, a couple of listens before you kind of know where you want it to go.
Well, and everybody participates, you know, as far as finding the structure, what we think works, what doesn't. Mm-hmm. You know, you kind of filter through and pretty soon you got
right
the meat and potatoes of the song.
Sure. Yeah. Any influences you guys kind of go to every once in a while, or is it always expanding?
I mean, we all like just too much music. We're all experts, and we know what's good and what's bad.
Is there a blues guy? Is there a rock guy, a punk guy kind of thing?
I'm kind of like the bluesy guy. That's kind of where my roots are. Mike's kind of a little bit of the metal guy, and Chris is kind of like classic rock guy,
yeah,
right?
But it does have that blues root. It's a rooted thing there.
Sure.
You know, but we're not blues, but that's where he comes from.
Right.
Yeah.
You can hear it in the music,
yeah,
which is a real, real cool thing. We've done three off the new EP, SOK. Are we going to go for four, or are we going to switch it up a little bit here?
We're going to do one. Drive-In, it's off of our second? Third EP.
Okay.
So this one's called Drive-In.
Sons of Kong in the WAPL Tundraland Garage.
Do what you do.
Ryan from Sons of Kong out of Green Bay. And we're talking with Joe, Chris, and Mike, Sons of Kong collectively. I had to wait for you, apparently, Joe, because the Sons of Kong name, you were the one that has to explain Sons of Kong.
Oh, yeah. So we went through a lot of names. I think we started out as Figure Four in the leg locks, but it was just too many words. So we came up with a list, and we kind of all voted on them. And at the time, we had another guy that was playing with us, guitar, and he kind of mentioned Sons of Kong, and we kind of mulled it around a little bit, and we're like, yeah, that one, that's the one. And then Josh quit. So Sons of Kong is left as three members, and that's kind of how we got the name. Josh gave it to us.
Got it. So it's a heritage thing.
Man. Yeah, totally.
I like it. Mile of Music, this is your first time playing Mile of Music. Obviously, first time playing the garage here.
Yeah.
But Mile of Music, what are you expecting out of the festival this year?
I've just heard nothing but really great things. Music lovers come to listen and check stuff out, so we're hoping we maybe get a few new fans.
Absolutely. From the area that usually is a nice, like, oh, these guys are from Green Bay? Really?
Yeah, right.
You know, one of those things. Gigs going on. Where are you playing at Mile? Michael has all the information for that one.
Thursday night, we're at Mill Creek. We're opening the night, I believe, at 8:10.
It's a good rocking place to kick it off.
So excited to be there. And then Saturday, we are at the Paper Valley Ballroom.
Okay.
We're kicking off the day Saturday at noon.
And you've played the ballroom. We were talking off air a little bit about you played the ballroom for a wedding.
No, we were hanging out at a friend's wedding. We played down the street at Chadwick's for the after party. So
gotcha.
At least we've been to the venue.
After party is so much better than the actual
wedding. It was, yeah.
I got to say, John, if these guys played a wedding, all the old people would leave early. More cake for you guys, right?
One kick-ass wedding. Well, we're going to wrap things up here in the Tenderland WAPL Mile Music Garage. Thank you very much again. Running sound for us, the maestro, Mark Goldie from Rock Garden Live.
Awesome.
CW14, Sunday nights, 10 o'clock. You could catch out that awesome show. And tomorrow, coming up, 9 a.m., Len.
We have Wild Adriatic from New York State, Mile Music favorites. People have fallen in love with that band and kind of made them Appleton's adopted son, I think, from their previous Mile of Music experiences and their trips through town.
They've just hung out for the last, like, 2-3 weeks here.
Yeah, they've been around the area. Also a three-piece band.
Yeah.
And a lot of sound, a lot of fun with those guys. And then tomorrow afternoon back here at 5, you guys have a great group, Kurt Gunn and his band, with a special guest, Maxwell Jones,
Max Jones on guitar. Is going to rip it up.
Who absolutely amazes people these days. If you've not gone to see Max Jones in any one of the 712 bands he's currently playing in.
Yeah.
Yeah. Everybody wants his services on the guitar. Check it out tomorrow on the live stream at WAPL.com on the 105.7 WAPL Facebook page.
Yeah.
We'll be kicking off a little after 9 o'clock each morning and just a couple minutes after 5 every afternoon here in the Tenderland Mile of Music Garage.
Yeah, stop by. Open to the public. We've got some got some creepers out there right now eating Stone Arch Pizza, which we highly encourage.
And we want to thank Brian and the whole crew at Tenderland for stepping up again this year.
Absolutely. Steve and everybody down at Stone Arch for doing it again.
And thanks to Sons of Kong, man.
Absolutely.
Thanks for coming in, guys.
Give it
thanks
up
for
guys.
Having us. Yeah, you guys are awesome.
You got one to take us out on? A banger?
Yeah.
This one's called Back Again.
Sons of Kong in the Mile of Music Garage.
Coming back again. When it's all over, well, I just hope it's not pretend. Now you're leaving me, boy. Why you leaving me, boy? No. Now you're leaving me, boy. Now you're
Sons of Kong in the WAPL Thunderland Mile of Music Garage. Thank you, guys.
Yeah, thanks for having us. It's a blast.
105.7 WAPL and WBAY TV2 host the Caring for Kids Mediathon, presented by Shields, Wednesday, August 9th, with Children's Hospital of Wisconsin, Fox Valley. Listen for a day of brave children and their families from